You need a pair of special eclipse glasses, like these. Totality.
Now, if there's one person who knows a thing or two about a total solar eclipse, it is Bill Nye, the science guy. He's been educating children and adults alike about this exciting celestial event and the science behind it. And we're lucky to have the man himself with us right now. Bill Nye joins us now from Fredericksburg, Texas, at the Planetary Society's Eclipse-O-Rama event. The peak time for stargazers there is about 2:32 p.m. Eastern time. Bill, great to see you. I see you have the glasses there. I've got my glasses here. I mean, I don't know. If I put them on, I can't really read the teleprompter. Hey, let's just wing it here. Tell us about what you're going to be expecting to see where you are. It looks a little cloudy behind you. I'm a little worried about your perspective there, Bill.
Well, it's a little cloudy, but it is, as we say in sailing, burning off.
Good.
If you look, or I can't look at it right now, the disk of the sun is there with a little partial cloud cover between us and the sun, but it's fine. It's going to be a great experience. I've been in a total solar eclipse in 2002 when it was a little cloudy. It's still amazing, you guys. It goes dark. It turns to night in a few moments. And you talked about the eclipse glasses. They are, even though these are cardboard with Mylar lenses, they are completely effective. And you can stare right at the sun with them. Regular sunglasses do not work, everybody. Do not do it. And as I say all the time, we've all looked at the sun. If you've ever played the outfield and there's a fly ball, you look at the sun for a moment. But these glasses are so much darker.
They're so much darker, Bill.
I encourage everybody.
And you can't mess with Mother Nature here, right?
No, you can't.
Yeah.
And just think what it was like in ancient times when people didn't know what was going on.
Yeah.
You know, whereas now modern astronomers can predict it within less than a hundredth of a second. It's remarkable.
Yeah, and we've seen some notable folks out there try to look up during an eclipse. You really shouldn't do that, no matter what anybody tells you. Just don't do that. But, Bill, I also wanted to ask you, what about our little pets and animals that we have in our lives? What happens with those little guys? I've got my dog, Duke. I'm worried about what I want to take him outside to watch it, but I suppose, does he need his glasses too? What's the deal with that?
Well, I've spent time with dogs. I've spoken at least two dogs quite a bit. They if it's night, they do their night thing. If it's day, they do their day thing. I think Duke will be fine. I think if you try to get Duke to wear the eclipse glasses, I'm predicting you won't have much success. I mean, you can try it. But
well, he's a beagle, so I definitely will
Duke
not have any success.
Dog. He's far above other dogs. I understand that. But
yes.
He may not get the whole eclipse thing right away.
I barely have success putting them on myself. And just talk about, if you can, Bill, I mean, this is going to be such an amazing event that we're all going to watch as a nation, which, you know, there aren't many things like that anymore that bring us together in a positive way. Talk about that, why this is so special, why this is so important.
Well, we are unique in the solar system, and we're probably unique in the galaxy, in the situation where our moon blocks the same width of sky as our sun. There's no place else in the solar system where that happens, but it happens here. It probably doesn't happen any other place nearby galactically, and so appreciate it. It's a remarkable thing where it goes completely dark when you're in the path underneath the shadow, and you can see the sun's come out here, and I'm pretty hopeful it'll be out all day. And the thing is, it's amazing. We all want to stare at it, look up at it, and enjoy it. But the other thing,
that's right.
What do we all do all the time now? Everybody's got a phone. Everybody wants to take pictures, want to take selfies.
Yeah.
We're obsessed with taking pictures. Okay. But just take these few minutes and be present. Be in the moment. And look up with your glasses on. Enjoy that when it goes completely dark. If you're in the path, you can take them off. But also look around. Because I'm hoping that everybody, the 30, maybe even 40 million people who experience this, will be with others.
That's it.
Other citizens of Earth.
That's right. We're
and
all
so
going to experience it together.
We'll have this shared experience.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's such a wonderful sentiment there, Bill. I got to go, but thanks so much for doing this. Really appreciate it. We'll put our glasses on one last time, and I'll And I'll thank you for joining us, and thank everybody out there for joining us. Enjoy the eclipse for everybody.
We are just hours away from a solar eclipse that you will likely talk about years from now. Some 32 million Americans will be in the so-called path of totality later this afternoon, and that means from Texas to Maine, they will be plunged into darkness when the moon blots out the sun for about four minutes. But if you're not lucky enough to be in that narrow band, worry not. 99% of Americans will see at least a partial eclipse. And this reminder, of course, be sure to wear those special eclipse glasses to avoid permanently damaging your eyes. It will be another 20 years before the next total solar eclipse is visible in the contiguous United States. We're covering all the angles of this truly rare event. CNN's Rosa Flores, Ed Lavandera, Harry Enten, they are all in the totality zone. Rosa, let's start with you. You're in Kerrville, Texas. What kind of crowds are expected there?
The crowds are Texas-sized, Wolf, but can you see me right now? Because I really can't see anything. I think I might be experiencing totality. Well, no, totality is not happening just yet. We do have a little bit of cloud cover, but I've got to say, Wolf, a while ago, I couldn't see any blue skies. The blue skies are starting to happen here, so these clouds might be parting. As Wolf was saying, having the proper eyewear is key for humans and also perhaps for animals. I have some guests here with me. Lana from Bandera and her little littles. And I have a few other people, if you want to come right closer to me, around me, because our pets are so integral in our families. And I'm wondering if littles has glasses for the eclipse.
Littles does not have glasses, but I do have a pair, and if she pays attention at all, which I'm not sure she will, I'll cover her eyes. So with my hand, or I'll just set her up in my lap and into her little carrier bag. So
littles will be protected.
Protected, yes.
Do you have glasses for your pets?
We have a couple extra.
Now, are they smaller glasses or larger glasses? Do they look like these?
The ones with the special code on the back, the official ones.
Yeah. And are they
NASA
small?
Approved? No, they're just those ones.
And one of the things that makes Kerrville so special is that it's experiencing two eclipses in 6 months.
Yes.
You told me that you were here for the one prior.
Yes.
Why is it so special to be in Kerrville for this one too?
Well, it's just all of the people, and we just get together, and it's so expensive where I live in Bandera, and I can park here for free and enjoy the wonderful experience of all the Kerrville people, and she gets to walk around the river, so we're happy.
And she is from Bandera. We were just there. That's the cowboy capital of the world.
Yes, it is. Cowboy capital of the world. We do shootouts on Main Street, and it's a lot of fun.
Thank you so much for your time. I appreciate it. And Wolf, according to the mayor of this city, they're expecting about 100,000 people. That means the population of the city is going to grow about fourfold by the time totality begins. Wolf, back to you.
Exciting day for so much of the country indeed. Rosa Flores in Kerrville, Texas for us. I want to go to CNN's Ed Lavandera right now. He's in Dallas, Texas, the largest U.S. city in the path of totality. Ed, you're there at the Dallas Zoo. Tell us what you're expecting there.
Oh, we've got a great day planned, Wolf. We are going to be monitoring the animal reaction to the total eclipse. There are a number of zoos that are in the path of this eclipse, and so we are going to be monitoring them. We're actually going to be asking for help from the public as well, because there's very little research that has been done to animal reaction to what happens, what animals do during a total eclipse. We're here in the Dallas Zoo in the savannah area. We've got elephants over here. We got zebras out there. This is Tobogo. The giraffe over here, who will be our co-host during this time, and is a little bit of a prima donna because they don't really stand next to you when you're doing the live shot, but we'll entice Tobogo over here with some lettuce at some point. And one of the things that they're going to be watching for is just the reaction. And so a couple of things to expect. is, you know, in 2017 during that eclipse, some animals behaved in a rather odd way at times. And even though it happens quickly, so one of the things that they're looking for is just that animal reaction. It could be anything from they think it's nighttime, they put themselves to sleep. It could be that there's a perceived threat, so they gather around their young. Flamingos did that. So we will be trying to monitor this as best as we can here during the eclipse. And if anywhere in the path of this eclipse, if you see anything about animals reacting to what is happening out there, it's gonna be a really interesting time. And we spoke with some of the officials here at the Dallas Zoo to get their perspective on what they'll be looking for and watching very closely here throughout the day.
We're just going to be monitoring the animal behavior, making sure that they seem comfortable, and just seeing if we see anything that seems a little bit out of the norm. We're not really expecting to see too much because my hunch is that they're probably going to assume that it's sort of like a thunderstorm rolling in where it gets really dark really quick, but we'll see.
So Wolf, you know, millions of people all across the Dallas-Fort Worth area. As you mentioned, this is one of the largest areas with the greatest population being able to watch this eclipse today. It's a little bit cloudy today, but you know, that darkness will settle in, a great deal of excitement building up for what we're expected to see here this afternoon.